Kids, welcome to Bible Discovery. I'm so excited for summer to be here soon. Are you? One thing I like to do in the summer is go swimming. When it's hot outside, it's nice to be able to jump in the water and cool off, or even just float there and look at the sky. Hey, can you do a back float? I can. How about on your stomach? Can you float on your stomach? I bet some of you can. How about on your knees? Or can anyone float in the water standing up? Of course not. But someone in today's story could stand up and walk on top of the water. Let's watch it.
Jesus had been teaching crowds of people by the Sea of Galilee. It was getting late, so he told his disciples to get into the boat and go to the other side of the sea. Jesus sent the crowds away and went up on the mountain to pray by himself. That evening, the boat was far from the shore. The wind blew and the waves tossed the boat around. Jesus was still on the mountain, alone. Around 3 a.m, Jesus came toward his disciples walking on the sea. When the disciples saw Jesus, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they cried. Right away, Jesus spoke to them, "Have courage, it's me, do not be afraid." Peter answered, "Lord, if it really is you, tell me to come to you on the water." So Jesus said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and started walking on the water toward Jesus. But when Peter saw how strongly the wind was blowing, he was afraid. Peter began to sink. "Lord, save me," he cried. Jesus reached out his hand and grabbed Peter. Jesus said, "You have little faith. Why do you doubt?" They got into the boat and the wind stopped. Then everyone in the boat worshiped Jesus and said, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Jesus proved that he can be trusted. His miracles, teaching, death, and resurrection show that he is who he says he is. Only Jesus can save us when we look to him in faith.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Julia from East Orange, New Jersey asks,
"How can I have a stronger faith?"
Oh, Julia, that is a question we all need to keep asking ourselves. Great question. So here's the thing. We know that faith needs to be grown. It's kind of like a muscle. Some people have called it a muscle that you have to keep exercising and stretching it so it grows and becomes stronger. And so how do we do that? Well, there are a few ways that we can do that. The first one I can think of is by spending more time in the Bible. The more we read the Bible, the more we study it, the more we understand who God is, the way he works, the greater confidence we have in him. We know how we're to live. And so reading the Bible is perhaps one of the greatest ways you can grow in your faith. Other ways are prayer, talking with God, asking him to grow you, asking him to help you learn and to live on faith. Another way is by worshiping, being part of a church. This is why it's so important that we're part of a family of faith and we gather regularly and worship together and study together and talk through these things, learn from one another. But all these things lead us to this one idea that I think is really important you hear. You have to stretch your faith. You have to put yourself in positions that are uncomfortable at times to grow in that faith. Think again about muscles. Think about, you know, lifting weights. Lifting weights is not easy. You have to strain and stretch yourself and you add more weight and there are times you're like, "I don't know if I can do this," but you keep pushing. And it's through that exertion that your muscles grow stronger. If you never put weights on the barbell and just lifted an empty barbell, you're not gonna really gain muscle. So it's the same thing with our faith. If we're never stretching ourselves, if we're never stepping into those uncomfortable areas of life, if we're never sitting down with that person in the cafeteria and praying that God opens a conversation to talk about your faith with him or her, then you're not gonna grow as much. It's through those uncomfortable, stretching moments that we really grow. So I wanna encourage you to do that. Share your faith with other people. Go on mission trips. Live for Christ day by day, and you will see your faith grow by leaps and bounds, I believe, when you do that. So I hope that has been helpful. And again, that's something that we all need to be doing. So question back for you, who or what are you looking to be secure? Where is your faith found?
Jesus' disciples found themselves in a dangerous storm. One thing that I love about this story is that even though Jesus was still way back on the mountain, he knew about their troubles and came to save them. Jesus showed he is God by walking on water. Not only was this something miraculous that only could happen by God's power, it is also an example of God's love for us. Jesus did not walk away from his disciples and walk away from danger. He walked right into it. He strolled right into the middle of the storm to be with his disciples. Peter showed great courage and faith when he stepped out of the boat, but it didn't last long in the face of the storm. When he got scared and started to sink, he called out for Jesus. And Jesus didn't wait to save him. Jesus didn't say, "Sorry, Pete, looks like you'll have to swim back to the boat." That's not what Jesus said. Jesus saved him right away. And Jesus wasn't angry that Peter got scared and doubted, but he did want Peter to have more faith. When they got back to the boat, Jesus calmed the storm and all the disciples worshiped Jesus. Jesus proved that he can be trusted. And not just the disciples in the boat, but we can trust him too. All of his miracles that we read in the Bible, all of his teaching, his death, and his resurrection, all of that shows us that he is who he says he is and that we can trust him. How will you trust Jesus this week? See you later. Have a great week.